So I had to start realizing.
What are you saying right now? What's it called?
Habbo Hotel. You don't remember that?
No.
Oh, wow. Okay. So Habbo Hotel was literally like the Lego version of like maybe Sims. Nah, not even Sims.
It's like an 8-bit Sims.
Yeah, it's not Sims like you're telling the person. You are the person, and you just get to type in, customize your person, and go to these rooms and
customize your own rooms.
It's like a PC thing.
Yeah, so it'll show like a third person like room, like a 3D space.
Okay.
And you're just a little character walking in that space, and you linked up with all these random ass people across the globe and shit.
What's your craziest story from there?
Seeing how much people were horny as fuck. Yo, they would block out all the fucking horny words and shit. Mm-hmm. So you'd be like, you'll see people be like, yo, I want to bubble you or some shit. they'll block the mature word and put bubble. So it's just like, yo, yeah, let's bubble right now or some shit. And like, you would have...
Like, what's not said is understood.
Yeah, so it was even more fucking funny because there are certain furniture you could collect. So people would buy beds and shit.
That's hilarious.
And then two characters would just lie on the bed and they would just type like, yo, doing this. I'm like, this is fucking weird.
That's hilarious. So wait, but they could just do that in the open and people are just gathered around, just
watching.
People walk in the room and walk back out.
Yeah. It's funny when you walk in the room and you just walk back out like, nah, fuck this. This shit is lame.
Rap battles were funny, though.
Yo, because it was funny because you had to be fast with the fingers.
Did you tell you? That's what I'm saying. Like,
niggas have to write bars. I remember I tried to do that, but I'm like, I type so slow.
That's hilarious, man.
Yeah, Habbo Hotel is a fucking fun game.
That sounds like a vibe. Shout out
to Habbo, bro.
They brought that shit to iPhone. I checked it. Like, I hear you, but I think younger me would have been fucking with that.
Yeah.
For sure. Like, holy fuck. Because I remember every time after school, I'm like, we go home and log into Habbo Hotel. Mm-hmm. And
as a member.
The most lucrative shit was, fam, at a certain point, if you've been in it long enough, yo, you could start scamming mans for their shit. Oh, I was going crazy.
All they need to do is just merge crypto into that shit.
Huh?
That would be crazy.
Crypto, you said, Andre? Yeah.
Like a crypto Habbo type shit.
Ooh, they might.
I wouldn't be surprised if they had something like that.
They might do that.
Something meta. Put something like. Yeah, put it in meta or something like that. Have a Habbo VR world.
How do you scam people in
there? Okay, so there was a bunch of these games, right?
Okay.
There were certain games on Habbo that people like created, and it just became like household like things to kind of just throw out, like if you want to throw it yourself. But a majority of people were doing it to scam people out of their shit because Habbo had a whole like chunk of like these items, like furniture shit, like that were rare and fucking all that bullshit. And the thing is, that was crazy about it is because you had to actually use real money to actually acquire some of these things, right?
Yeah.
So some of these things never existed because if you weren't playing early or whatever, then you wouldn't have got it.
Right.
So they had, so I remember this one, I'll never forget it. It was called the Habbo throne chair. And that was like the most expensive fucking thing you could ever cop. Like people were paying real life money to actually cop it.
Yeah.
So anyways, Habbo had a whole shit ton of fucking like furniture items, all this bullshit that you could collect, and they're of rarity. And some people would, what's it called? They would throw games or whatever. And I just remember one of them was called Falling Fernie. So you had to basically just put yourself in you get a whole group of people in your room, right? Mm-hmm. And they all have to just stand randomly. So you say like it's me, you, and Dre, right? Mm-hmm. And say like we're gonna have one mole in there because we want to take everybody's shit. So, it's crazy. So, all four of us are in the game, right?
Yeah.
So, I'll be like, yo, Marcus, I'm gonna tell you, like, literally, I'll text you on the side or some shit, MSN you or whatever. Just be like, yo,
the right answer.
I'll be like, yo, I'm about to drop the furniture in the top left. Make sure you start running there or whatever. Because once I drop the chair, you go sit in. So, every time you sit in a chair, you're safe.
Yes.
You know? So, it was like playing like musical chairs almost, but without the music. So, at a certain point, people, if you lose,
Yo, this sounds hilarious.
It was funny as fuck. As a kid,
I just imagine like Marcus's character just inching closer to that left side.
Yeah, like some people caught on. Like, nah, this is a scam. And when managers be like, "Yo, this is a scam," you kick them out of your room. Like, get the fuck out of here, nigga. Don't expose no shit.
Kick them out the room when they speak.
Yeah, when they start speaking up, kick them out the room, bitch. So,
you sound like that fucking Star Wars character.
Literally,
it's a trap.
So at a certain point, the whole goal is to incentivize people to keep paying to stay.
Yeah.
So it's like, all right, yo, just give me, I remember what people had to pay, but people had to pay either like furniture shit or whatever. And
also, it was like a lottery and you had to like pay like $2 to play
with furniture though. Like,
okay,
it's like if you had no fucking if you had no form of like currency or furniture or whatever, like, yo, there's no point, try again next time or whatever. But every time, so my whole objective as a judge is to make sure Marcus is getting the win every time,
right?
So that everybody just says, "Yo, I'm out of shit to give" or whatever, and then you're like, "Ah, Marcus won, yo, he won this big."
You won everything.
Yeah, not even just. I think it's that, or you just win like the grand prize. Like somebody would be like, "Yo, we're gonna give away like this one couch that like you have to sign up to be a member for it." So it was lucrative, and that's what made the game even more fun. Because
How much did you get out of it?
I don't even remember that shit, to be honest. But I did get a couple rare shit. Scammed a lot of people. And it was good. And on top of that too, I remember I was so obsessed of like getting those fucking coins, but you have to use real money. And I remember, I don't know how I found it, but I found some random ass number that you could call. Every time
When was this?
Nigga, I was like
years ago.
Like like a decade or two. No, not even a decade. Like 15 years or so. I don't remember, man. I was young as fuck.
How old were you? Like,
I don't remember. That's what I'm saying. I don't remember. Like
nine or 10.
That's what I'm thinking. Like 10, 11. Like I don't remember. I was young as fuck. I just remember the internet was my friend, and I was just searching everything for answers. So I remember I found the Habbo, this random ass number that says you, because on the Habbo Hotel website you can call for a certain amount of, you could call a certain amount of times and collect a certain like a smaller amount of credits. And I'm like, oh, okay, cool. Like, what's the harm in calling, right? So I found another number that gives you more guap, and I'm like, what the fuck? This is crazy. So I kept calling and calling and calling and calling. And I was getting stacks. Like, I can't even lie.
How does that even work?
But yeah, I don't even know how. I was just like, fuck it. But then
they probably charged you to your
phone. So I remember one time I was at my aunt's house and I called it like crazy. And my aunt's like, yo. She hit me. She's just like, yo, have you been calling this random number, blah, blah? I'm like, no. What number is that? 1-800 number? What am I doing calling those numbers?
Yeah.
And she never told me, but it sounded like she was cheese because that shit probably racked up a lot of money.
How much would that have?
I don't know. I was young. I did not check. I didn't
care.
I wasn't trying to find out. I just heard that, this number is getting me free coins. So I'm like, fuck it. And I just kept stacking and stacking and stacking and stacking until I started to realize that the number is charging people in real life that I know. And I'm like, let me stop calling. And I slowly came off of Habbo just because I started to realize, I'm like, it was just stupid. I'm like, yo, I'm playing this game just to sit on furniture. I'm like,
You said you had racks?
I had stupid amount of like.
Like more coins. Than 1,000?
I know, like, you could purchase, like, all right.
Let me give you a number I just looked up. So 630 credits diamonds would cost $70.
No, hold on. So
it's probably cheaper.
It's
probably cheaper, but then I just remember that when you converted the coin, so say like if I paid $5, right?
Mm-hmm.
Say like $10 gives me a gold bar. Gold bar was worth a certain amount.
Right.
Say like 100 Habbo coins. Yeah. But then like a $50 bag was like 50 Habbo coins or whatever. But it will go down. Mm. So it's like $15 real life was $100 in Habbo.
Mm.
Or $10 or $5 was a $50 in Habbo and shit. So I was collecting like that, and I had a lot of 50 bags. That's all I can remember. And I was just like, I couldn't tell you how much that was, but I remember I had a whole sidewall full of 50 bags, and I'm like, yeah, I'm rich.
I'd be livid if I see my phone bill just $80.
Yeah, it was ridiculous.
Yeah, what is this?
Yeah. I don't know. I don't know what you're getting charged for.
I'm not too lying.
Yo, I actually almost got booked still. Yeah, I almost got booked. I remember.
You went back after you told her you don't know?
No. So,
criminal return to the scene of the crime.
My stepbrother was asking me something about it. And I was just like, he's like, yo, how do you get all this? I'm like, yo, don't worry, I have a way. And this guy's dad heard me, and he was like, you have a way? And I guess he's seen the calls on this shit. He's like, he started putting two and two together. He's like, yo, you've been calling this shit? I know, what the heck? But that was my way of getting guap.
Oh, my God.
But when it was so funny. I was just like, yo, don't worry, I have a way of getting money. Mm-hmm. And he's just like, it's like he was preying the whole time, like detective work, like where it is. So, yo, you've been calling this number. I was like, nah, I don't know what you're talking about.
That's smiling mad crazy as you say that.
On me.
I know exactly who, too.
Yeah.